Hello and welcome to this interview. And today I'm really excited about interviewing somebody who is an epitome of excellence, hard work, and integrity. So let me welcome here for this interview, distinguished Toastmasters, Haritosh Srivastav. Hello, Haritosh. Welcome to the interview.
थैंक यू सो मच ताइबा एंड मुझे बार बार डिस्टिंग्विश्ड टोस्टमास्टर बुलाने की जरूरत नहीं है. आई एम फाइन, यू कैन जस्ट कॉल मी हरितोष. आई प्रिफर टू बी कॉल्ड लाइक हरितोष. थैंक यू.
नो बट आई लव कॉलिंग यू डिस्टिंग्विश्ड टोस्टमास्टर्स हरितोष श्रीवास्तव बिकॉज़ यू हैव अर्न दैट टाइटल फॉर योरसेल्फ एंड यू एक्चुअली डू जस्टिस टू दैट टाइटल. सो दैट इज व्हाई आई लव कॉलिंग यू डीटीएम. देयर इज अ रीजन.
थैंक यू.
सो लेट्स बिगिन.
या
So without any further ado, today would be a very interesting interview wherein I'll be sharing a lot of snippets about Haritosh's life, right from his childhood, from the place he was born and brought up, his school life, to his college, and then finally different companies that he joined. And then most importantly, how he started off his Toastmasters journey. तो आज हम बात करेंगे हरितोष की स्टार्टिंग से, अर्ली लाइफ के बारे में. तो हरितोष, मैं जानना चाहूंगी व्हाट वाज योर टाउन लाइक एंड व्हाट आर योर अर्ली चाइल्डहुड मेमोरीज अबाउट योर स्कूल एंड अर्ली लाइफ.
थैंक यू सो मच ताइबा, बहुत ही अच्छा सवाल है आपका. एंड आई थिंक जैसे मैंने आज भी एक इंटरव्यू किया था दीपक शर्मा सर का, उन्होंने कहा था कि ही इज वर्क इन प्रोग्रेस. आई से आई हैव जस्ट स्टार्टेड माय वर्क, सो एंड आई एम स्टिल लर्निंग. सो आई वाज बोर्न इन ब्रॉट अप इन अ स्मॉल टाउन कॉल्ड जौनपुर. जौनपुर वाराणसी के जस्ट बगल में है. वाराणसी इज वेरी फेमस आफ्टर नरेंद्र मोदी नाउ, सो एवरीबॉडी नोज. सो इट इज अबाउट 60 किलोमीटर फ्रॉम वाराणसी. एंड वहां पे मेरा जन्म हुआ था. माई अर्ली एजुकेशन वॉज डन देयर. एंड इट इज एन इंटरेस्टिंग कॉन्वर्जेशन बिकॉज मेरा फर्स्ट अप टू क्लास 8 आई वॉज इन सरस्वती शिशु मंदिर, विच इज प्योरली हिंदी एंड संस्कृत. एंड देन आई स्टडीड इन शिया कॉलेज विच इज हिंदी एंड उर्दू. सो आई गॉट द फ्लेयर ऑफ बोथ Hindi, English, less English actually, but little bit of Urdu. Coincidentally, जहाँ पे मैं रहता हूँ उसका नाम भी उर्दू बाजार है. So very small town. I studied over there from pure Hindi medium. काफी अच्छा time था. I was there till 2002 when I completed my intermediate, and then I moved on. So since then. Not been back to Jaunpur except for a few months, and that we'll talk about a little bit later. But 2002 से जब मैं निकला उसके बाद से मैं proper Jaunpur का निवासी नहीं रह गया. And now it is 2020. Just a zero make 18 years difference.
Yeah. बहुत interesting है. मतलब आपने पहले हिंदी और संस्कृत medium school से पढ़ाई करी, फिर एक उर्दू और हिंदी मीडियम स्कूल, एंड देन नाउ द वे यू स्पीक इंग्लिश सो फ्लुएंटली एंड सो नाइसली एंड सो कॉन्फिडेंटली, इट्स सो अमेजिंग टू हियर यू. तो मतलब पता ही नहीं चलता कि आप इतने मल्टीलिंगुअल होने के बावजूद, मतलब हाउ डू यू मैनेज टू लर्न सो मेनी लैंग्वेजेस एट दैट टू विद सच कॉन्फिडेंस एंड पॉइज, इट्स जस्ट सो अमेजिंग. नाउ I would like to move ahead and ask ki how did you decide engineering, or how did you decide the stream for your college? How did that happen, and how was the college life like, and how did it lead to you going out from, you know, that college to the corporate world?
Thank you. Very good question, Taiba. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल लेट मी टेल यू आई एम नॉट मल्टीलिंगुअल. मुझे हिंदी और इंग्लिश ही आती है, थोड़ी बहुत इंग्लिश आती है और हिंदी आती है. उसके अलावा मुझे और कोई लैंग्वेज अभी नहीं आती है. आई एम ट्राइंग टू लर्न फ्रेंच बट आई एम वेरी बैड एट इट. सो आई वॉज इन जौनपुर 2002 तक में था एंड देन हाउ आई चोज इंजीनियरिंग वॉज इट इज वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग स्टोरी कि जब भी बचपन में कोई भी गिफ्ट में टॉय या कुछ भी मुझे मिलता था या कोई भी मुझे पेरेंट्स दिला के आते थे दैट टॉय विल नॉट लास्ट फॉर मोर देन टू डेज क्योंकि आई विल डिसअसेंबल ऑल द पार्ट्स एंड ऑल द एक्सेसरीज ऑफ दैट एंड इन मोस्ट ऑफ द टाइम्स वो वापस जोड़ नहीं पाता था
तो रिवर्स इंजीनियरिंग थे बचपन से
या सो एंड जब भी लोग देखते थे अच्छा ये फिर से इसने कर दिया फिर से एक और खिलौना गया तो मतलब ये तो इंजीनियर बनेगा सो दैट लेबल वॉज ऑलरेडी देयर बट आई वॉज लकी आई वॉज नॉट फोर्स टू बी एन इंजीनियर अनलाइक लॉट ऑफ kids to say who are like forced to become an engineer or doctor my parents were pretty okay to whatever stream you want to my father by the way is a retired district homeopathic officer so and my tauji is an engineer I mean he is retired engineer so I had both the options whatever I feel like the reason I chose math was my drawing was very bad and I had very too much problem in remembering the terms of biology so math acha lagta tha you can just learn the formula and see the application and you'll be good biology ke liye bahut mehnat karni padti thi medical field mein bahut hi zyada competition hai so I thought I'll choose the easy one which actually suits me so that's how I chose engineering and So I chose math in intermediate and then for next one year in 2003 first time main ghar se bahar nikla that was 60 km Varanasi and as they say ki it is very important to have the right association right friends right people surround you so that was the year I think I had the worst of it to say coincidentally main apne फादर के एक फ्रेंड के बेटे के साथ रहता था एंड देन आई वाज द कॉलेज टॉपर इन इंटरमीडिएट बट सिंस ही वाज नॉट टू मच इनटू स्टडीज एंड आई थॉट माय लेवल वेंट रियली डाउन बिकॉज इफ यू आर स्टेइंग विद समवन एंड ही इज नॉट स्टडीइंग यू आल्सो गेट डीमोटिवेटेड लाइक ओके लेट्स चैट लेट्स प्ले लेट्स डू समथिंग सो वी यूज्ड टू डू एवरीथिंग एक्सेप्ट स्टडीज एंड And that's one regret I have. Maybe I could have studied more that year. I would have got a better college. Nevertheless, I think after 1 year, I got admission into a college in Dadri. Dadri is very famous. Next to Greater Noida, as part of UPTU, Uttar Pradesh Technical University, and. So next 2003 से लेके 2007 तक I did my engineering full time hostler I made tons of friends lifetime friends some of them are still very close friends and then I had very low confidence but one thing I did in my intermediate which really proved helpful and which I would give as a first advice to any youngster is plan ahead. And why I want to say this is you have to have some vision of what you want to be in future or what you want to do. Jab I was in intermediate, jab main intermediate mein tha, everything maths, physics, chemistry, sab kuch Hindi mein hota tha. But I knew ki I'm gonna do engineering or something where it is gonna be all English. So I used to make sure. That key, all the key terms I translate to English. So, for example, chemistry is rasayan, sastra, bhautiki, physics, things like those. And there are so many terms like gravity, gurutvakarshan, things like that. So, I used to do all the notes in Hindi. But for all the key terms, I used to find out. And books already used to have a lot of terms. But for other terms, I used to find out. And that I think proved to be a game changer for me when I went to engineering. Lot of people jo ki Hindi medium se aate hain, they struggle to understand the terms rather than yeah. understanding the concepts. Since I had done yeah. that pre-work, at least मुझे वो time नहीं लगता था कि concept पे time ज़्यादा देता था rather than understanding the key terms. So that helped. And 2006
शुरुआत ज़्यादा क्या कहते हैं enthusiastic learner थे. You used to always plan ahead of time. Like in Toastmasters meet. You are always prepared with all the roles and anything that's given to you on the spot. So you used to be that student in college also.
I could say that actually. Now when you say and I think back, I think I like to be organized. Mujhe plan karna aur pehle se preparation karna achha lagta hai. And this probably, I think ye mujhe aaya hai shayad mere dadaji se, grandfather se. He was very punctual. I've given a speech in Toastmasters also about him. And he was very punctual and he was very thorough with concepts. He used to prepare for anything. And I think that since I spent my early 14, 16 years fortunate to spend with him and my grandmother, I think I got those qualities. So, even in engineering times, it is very interesting times. Generally, what happens is ki jab engineering ke student hote hain, they are not much studying for first 4 months of a semester. And last one and a half months, they will do each and everything to study. So, 4 months puri masti karte hain. And last ke ek do mahine utni jyada padhai karte the. I was actually a little bit of reverse of that. So I was more of a consistent player, not exactly kachua, but a little bit more than that. So I used to study consistently for 1 to 2 hours right from the start. And I used to do the same towards the end of the semester. So jab sab koi 16, 17, 18 ghante padhai karta tha, I still used to study 3-4 hours and do a lot of masti. And my favorite spooky thing was that whenever any of the, I mean, hostel ka mahol thoda alag hota hai. Jab exam aata hai, everybody is going to other place and seeing kya, kaun kya pad raha hai. Mere friends jab bhi aate the, they used to find me sleeping. And they used to freak out, why is this guy sleeping? There is exam tomorrow and he's sleeping. And it was more of a preparation because I know I have done things that I supposed to do. So not an overconfidence, but if you are prepared, you know, okay, I think I can do that. And that used to help. I had a couple of good roommates in hostel who are still very good friends of me. And I think I still get connected to them. So I was really fortunate to have those because they were able to cope up with me. When everybody is studying and your roommate is sleeping, it's not a good scene. But they knew how I operate and they were very adjusting to that. So it helped. So in 2006, in our sixth semester, so actually in fifth semester, there was that first campus company came, Infosys at that time. Lot of was prepared. I believe only 6 or 7 people got selected from the college of 400 plus people. And I was not one of them. And I was devastated.
Okay.
I was devastated. But we kept on working hard. And I would myself feel very lucky and fortunate that in next semester, there were a few more companies. And I was privileged to get a job offer from a company called Mindtree, and I also had offer from Satyam, but I joined Mindtree. So 2007, I don't know, it's like mere saath kuch har baar ajeeb hi hota hai. Generally people have a lot of time after they complete engineering and before they're joining, they have 1 month, 2 month, 3 month, 4 months break. Mere case mein, my college finished on 14th June or something. And by 28 June, we had to leave for Bangalore because we have the joining on 1st July. And in those, and not only that, us do hafte mein bhi bahut sare formalities karne the ki ye medical certificate leke aao, ye banwa ke lao, wo banwa ke lao. So I was like, why was I lucky or was I unlucky to not get a break? So that's how 2007, second July, I joined Mindtree Limited in Bangalore along with my 13 more colleagues of the.
But Bangalore, you see, is a very interesting place. Like, jaise you had been like in UP only, Dadri mein aap rahe jaise. But then all of a sudden, north se seedhe south jana. How much of a change was that? And how did you find yourself there? And what was it like to spend time there? And for how many years you were there? So how was that journey like?
Thank you. So 2007, I joined Bangalore. I had no idea how do you get out of your... Say, first time I was out of my Hindi white cocoon, even though Dadri was different from my hometown. But this time it was like ki niche se jameen sarak jaane wala jaise kehte hain. Up till uske pehle English was a luxury, but wahan jaake English necessity ban gayi because you don't have any other option. So you have to speak in English, you have to do all the conversation, all the discussion in English, and otherwise they will start doing in Kannada, Tamil or Telugu. No offense to any South Indian language, they all are beautiful language, but in order for all of us to be on the same page, it's important ki hum English mein converse kare. And when you go out, you have to learn a bit of local language. So, and Kannada, as we know, Kannad we say in northern area, but it's actually called Kannada there. So Kannada was the main language there. So I was there for close to 4 years, I'll say more than 3.5 years. I started learning a bit of Kannada, which I failed, and I don't remember and even 0.001% of that. But I think this is one thing I learned, that if you are being somewhere, if you try to learn their language, try to learn their culture, try to understand their background, it helps broaden your perspective. Aapka nazariya badalta hai. Kai baar hamare andar bahut sare wo preconceived notion bhare hote hain ki wahan pe aisa hai, wahan pe aisa hai, but not everything is true. So give me one second, I think I need to put my laptop on charger.
Okay,
sorry about that. So, as I was saying, when you understand the local language, local culture, local cuisine, it helps you broaden your perspective. आपका नजरिया बदलता है और जो आपके अंदर में बहुत बार गलत चीजें भरी होती हैं वो निकल जाती हैं. कई बार biases होते हैं.
Actually, we humans carry a lot of biases when we go to a new place. हमें हमारे पेरेंट्स या कहीं ना कहीं रिश्तेदार या कोई ना कोई ऐसे माइंड में भर देता है, अरे वहाँ के लोग तो ऐसे होते हैं वैसे होते हैं. आई बिलीव ह्यूमन सब जगह ज्यादातर एक जैसे ही होते हैं, बहुत ज्यादा डिफरेंस होता नहीं है. इट्स बेसिकली आवर माइंडसेट एंड वे वी डील विद पीपल. तो वो प्री कंसीव नोशंस बहुत सारे लेके चलते हैं हम जब हम कहीं नई जगह पे जाते हैं. और जैसे आपने बोला, जब हम नई मतलब उस लैंग्वेज को एक्चुअल में उनके कल्चर को उनकी नजरिए से देखते हैं तो एक अपनापन सा महसूस होता है, हम उसमें फिर ज्यादा अच्छे से घुल पाते हैं.
करेक्ट. एंड एक चीज है कि हर जगह अच्छे लोग होते हैं और हर जगह बुरे लोग होते हैं. सो दैट इज ऑल्सो अ थिंग टू नो कि आइडेंटिफाई कि आपके लिए कौन सही है और कौन सही नहीं है, रिगार्डलेस ऑफ जो भी कल्चर बैकग्राउंड एंड ऑल. I had my best manager as my first manager, Jinto Varghese, there. And I still respect him a lot. I haven't met him. We planned to meet in US, but we could not. So I had my, lot of people had, they had bad managers. I said, my good managers outnumbers to one odd bad manager, to say. I had a number of managers.
And you were very lucky in that sense.
Yeah, I was lucky. I think I am lucky on that. Most of the managers I have worked with, they've been really, really helpful, really supportive, and everybody have their own merits and demerits, but no, when you feel empowered, when you feel included in the team, it helps. So in that perspective, yeah, I'll say except one odd manager, I would say I have been lucky to work with so many good managers.
Yeah. तो 2007 से चार साल यानी 2011 तक आप जो है मतलब बैंगलोर में रहे. उसके बाद बैंगलोर के बाद where was the next place that you headed?
Yes, so this is also interesting story. 2009 में my grandfather died and 2010 my grandmother also died and at that time my mother was also not feeling well and that time I consciously decided to that I have to move back to some place which is closer and which is like an overnight journey to my place. So though I had a lot of opportunities in Bangalore and it's a beautiful city, it's a beautiful place to live, it's a beautiful place for your career, I had to make a compromise and I had to shift to NCR because that was the closest place I could think about from my for my personal reasons to shift. So then in 2011 I joined another great organization called Sopra India Private Limited. Now it's Sopra Steria, Sopra has taken over Steria. I was there for 1.5 years. I made some really really close friends. बहुत ही अच्छा टाइम था वो 1.5 साल वहाँ पे. एंड आई हैड अनदर ग्रेट आई विल से माय लाइफ्स फर्स्ट लेडी मैनेजर वाज देयर एंड शी वाज रियली हेल्पफुल रियली इफेक्टिव इन ब्रिंगिंग आउट द बेस्ट इन ऑल ऑफ अस एंड बी इट फ्रॉम टेक्नोलॉजी डोमेन पर्सपेक्टिव और फ्रॉम इंटरपर्सनल रिलेशनशिप. एंड unfortunately she had some tragedy and she had to undergo a lot of things, but no, she really inspired us. And then in 2012 I joined TCS, Tata Consultancy Services. So since 2012 I am a proud TCSer or Tata family person. It's been close to, I think it will become 8 years in this August.
Yeah. तो TCS आपने 2012 में ज्वाइन करी, तो TCS के ये 8 साल कैसे रहे आपके लिए? एंड हाउ एंड व्हेन डिड टोस्टमास्टर्स हैपन ड्यूरिंग आई थिंक TCS में आके यू ज्वाइन टोस्टमास्टर्स राइट?
राइट.
सो टेल अस अबाउट दिस टोस्टमास्टर जर्नी अलोंग विद द TCS एक्सपीरियंस.
ओके, फॉर फर्स्ट ईयर फॉर माय टी My first year with TCS was like कि मैं तो छोड़ के चला जाऊंगा. I was a pure technical guy and for the very first year I did not, to be honest, I did not like the kind of work we were doing because I was so much into coding and technology and all those things and whenever you change a company it is an uncomfortable thing. So I was like एक आध साल के बाद निकल लेंगे. बट देयर आई एम आफ्टर क्लोज टू 8 years नाउ. सो आई थिंक देयर इज समथिंग स्पेशल अबाउट TCS दैट व्हेन पीपल से व्हेन यू जॉइन TCS इट्स वेरी हार्ड टू लीव एंड आई एग्री दैट. मेरी जर्नी काफी रोलर कोस्टर रही है एंड आई वुड से आई वाज द सेम गाय जो कि बैंगलोर से नोएडा आया था बिकॉज आई वॉन्टेड टू stay close to my family. But then TCS gave me opportunity to go overseas not only once, not only twice. In fact, abhi at this time I am on my third trip second time to UK. So I think there are always things like corporate politics, bias, and I'm not denying that there will be negativity. But one thing I've learned is that if you're doing good work, अगर आप अच्छा काम कर रहे हैं, अगर आप मेहनत से काम कर रहे हैं, अगर आप पैशन से काम कर रहे हैं, तो आपका काम आपसे ज्यादा बोलता है. और अगर आपका काम आपसे ज्यादा बोलता है तो आपको कहीं ना कहीं किसी न किसी फॉर्म में सफलता जरूर करेक्ट ना आपको बोलने की जरूरत पड़ती है और आपको किसी न किसी फॉर्म में सफलता मिलती रहती है अलग अलग समय पर. हो सकता है उस टाइम पे हम उसको ना पहचान पाए बट जब आप सोचेंगे व्हेन यू रिफ्लेक्ट बैक यू विल रियलाइज कि हाँ आई गॉट सम सक्सेस. सो आई थिंक दैट वे आई फील लकी एंड दिस हैज बीन अ ग्रेट एसोसिएशन विद टीसीएस फॉर क्लोज टू 8 years.
फर्स्ट जो मतलब बाहर ऑन साइट था वो कौन से ईयर में था और वो कहां पर था?
या सो 2015 में मैं पहली बार आया था यूके अलोंग विथ माय वाइफ. आई वाज गिवन अ रोल ऑफ सर्विस डिलीवरी मैनेजर फॉर वन ऑफ द फार्मा कस्टमर दैट वी वर्क फॉर एंड वी स्टिल वर्किंग फॉर इट फॉर 8 years नाउ. एंड दैट वाज लाइक कि वो छोटा सा लड़का जो हिंदी मीडियम सरस्वती शिशु मंदिर में पढ़ता था वहां से वो बनारस गया, वहां से वो दादरी गया, वहां से बैंगलोर गया, वापस नोएडा आया. बट वो कभी इंडिया से बाहर नहीं गया था एक्सेप्ट अगर वो कॉलेज का एक टूर था नेपाल का उसको छोड़ दें तो कभी कॉलेज से बाहर नहीं गया था कंट्री से बाहर नहीं गया था. दिस टाइम ये उसके लिए पहली बार था. सो अनदर कल्चरल शॉक टू से अभी तो इंग्लिश ही नहीं इंग्लिश अच्छी भी बोलनी थी क्योंकि you have to make sure कि जो आप बोल रहे हो वो सामने वाला समझे भी. It's not Indian English. You have to make sure that they understand what you speak. And so lot of learning, lot of exposure I got. And 2016, January 2016, we came back with my wife being pregnant. So we went two, we came two plus. So that was interesting conversation. And in between, I think I missed to talk about my wife. 2012, actually, after I joined TCS, after a few months, I got married to Roli. And I think I've been very privileged and fortunate to have her as my life partner. She's been a great pillar of support, a great strength to me. And we both complement each other on many aspects and on not so many aspects as well. But it has been a truly true partnership. And what I'm indebted to her is, when 2015, we had this opportunity starting in 2014. And she had started, she had her education and everything before marriage. And she had just started teaching in a school. And she chose to abandon her career to accompany me. She's still working on her career in different phases, but I think that was a great sacrifice from her side so that, you know, we both can get those kind of exposure, those kind of opportunities. So I'm always indebted to her for this.
When did Toastmasters happen then?
Oh, yes. Now, so main story happens. 2016, I came back. And when I say I had one odd bad manager, this is where the story comes. So, and I'm still grateful to him. So when I joined back in 2016 in India, we had a manager who was, just say, not ideal manager, not great manager. But one thing was that he will call meeting of all the project leads and he will again tell them that you guys need to improve your communication skills. You guys need to improve your communication skills. You guys need to improve your communication skills. Join Toastmasters. Join Toastmasters. Make sure your teams are joining Toastmasters. So I thought, when I'm being forced to join, go and attend Toastmasters, and actually more importantly, when I'm being forced to ask my teams to join Toastmasters, I should first try. I should make sure that I go. I like to be lead. I like to lead from front. अगर मैं अपनी टीम को बोलना हूँ कि तुम्हें ये करना चाहिए, और मैं वो खुद नहीं कर रहा हूँ, it's not the right example that we set, right?
Yeah.
मैं वो करके वो छोड़ दूँ, वो अलग चीज़ है. बट अगर मैंने वो किया ही नहीं है, मुझे वो पता ही नहीं है क्या है, और मैं दूसरे को प्रीच करूं कि नहीं तुम्हें ये करना चाहिए, सो आई थॉट दिस इज नॉट करेक्ट, वी ऑल नीड टू इम्प्रूव. सो आई अटेंडेड कपल ऑफ टोस्टमास्टर्स.
पता था क्या टोस्टमास्टर्स इतना कुछ स्पेशल बनेगा आपके लिए? डिड यू हैव एनी आईडिया?
I had no idea. I think first Toastmaster I attended in about, I believe in 2014 sometime. That's when we were forced to go and attend. I did not know what is it and just went there for an hour and like, ये क्या चल रहा है, कुछ बोल रहा है कोई, कोई है उसका जवाब कर रहा है. And I think, I remember there were some table topics there day. So I think my first ever table topic was, I think it's something related to dreams and making castles in air or something like that, something related to that. So I went there. I don't remember what exactly I spoke there, but bahuti, I'll say below standard was there, below average was there. But then I went out of India and then 2016 and the same manager was like again and again pounding that, oh, you guys should join Toastmaster, you guys should join Toastmaster. And I think I'm really grateful to him because had he not been so much adamant, insistent about that, probably maine join nahi kiya hota. So 2016 I joined Toastmaster after attending a few meeting because I wanted to be the person who practices what he preaches. So agar main apni team ko bol raha hu join karo to I should do it first. To maine join kiya and I really like the environment, bahut supportive environment hota hai. I don't think I need to tell you, but for our audience, ye aisi jagah hai jahan pe hum communication aur leadership ki we can say ki ye communication aur leadership improve karne ke liye ek gym ki tarah hai, jahan jaake aap प्रैक्टिस करते हो कि कैसे अपनी कम्युनिकेशन इम्प्रूव करनी है, कैसे अपनी लीडरशिप स्किल्स इम्प्रूव करनी है. एंड दिस इज नॉट अ प्लेस टू लर्न इंग्लिश, जस्ट टू क्लैरिफाई टू एवरीवन, ये इंग्लिश ट्यूशन क्लास नहीं है, ठीक है? तो अगर इफ यू थिंक दैट यू आर गोना लर्न इंग्लिश, प्रॉब्ली नॉट द बेस्ट चॉइस, बट इफ यू वॉन्ट टू इम्प्रूव योर कम्युनिकेशन, दिस इज द बेस्ट प्लेस. मोस्ट इकोनॉमिकल, most loving people are there and yeah. So 2016 is when my journey started and I was there for about 8 months, 9 months or so before I had to go to United States for my second trip. But wo 8 mahine golden the. I had my first mentor, Satya Priya, Toastmaster Satya Priya. I think she is not Toastmaster now, but no, she was the one who persuaded me, nahi, you should do that, you can do that. And I know I was so nervous for giving my first speech. Isko hum log icebreaker speech kehte hain. She took me to a conference room and she listened to my speech and then she suggested a few things. Then I updated my script and I gave it again and then few more suggestions. So uske baad, so that's how I started. And then I kept on going. So yeah, 4 years now. So yeah, great journey so far.
Actually, mentor का concept ही नहीं पता था. And you would be astounded to know, किसी ने मुझे जब मैं नोएडा 7 में थी एक project में, तो किसी ने मुझे ऐसे ही बोला था कि मेरे mentor ऐसे थे और वो मुझे इतना ज़्यादा motivate करते थे. तो मैंने किसी से पूछा कि ये mentor होता क्या है. But I had seriously no clue what is a mentor like in Toastmasters because मैं already ठीक ठाक बोल लेती थी, तो कभी किसी ने मुझे suggest ही नहीं किया कि mentor जैसा भी कुछ होता है. And right before I met you, तभी मुझे पता चला था there's something called a mentor. The day I met you, I will always say that, and I will, if I write a book, I will write that. That day was a game changer in my life. And
thank you.
I always say that no amount of gratitude can compensate for what, you know, for the kind of effort that you put in for your mentees. So, matlab, wo kahin na kahin, jaise aap hamesha kehte hain, aapke life mein bahut amazing mentors the. Kuch kafi sare se main mili hu, जिसे मार्क से मैं मिली
right.
और तरुण सर से मिल चुकी हूँ और इनसे नहीं मिली हूँ, ये वाले जो मेंटर हैं आपकी, ये जो मैम थी, बट एक ऐसे मेंटर जिन्होंने लाइक जो सबसे खास हैं आपके लिए, लाइक यू हैव हैड सो मेनी मेंटर्स
एंड वेरी वेरी गुड क्वेश्चन. आई थिंक कौन सबसे खास है या कौन सबसे खास है ये कहना बहुत ही ज्यादा मुश्किल होगा. आई कैन टॉक अबाउट अ फ्यू मेंटर्स आई हैड एंड आई थिंक मैं ऑडियंस पे छोड़ दूंगा कि वो डिसाइड करे कौन सबसे खास था. सो आफ्टर साथिया प्रिया देयर इज दिस टोस्ट मास्टर तरुण भार्गव सर. ही वॉज डिविजन डायरेक्टर फॉर नॉन टोस्ट मास्टर. एक डेजिग्नेशन होता है विच इज बेसिकली आप 15-16 क्लब मैनेज करते हो एक पर्टिकुलर एरिया का. एंड ही वॉज अ ग्रेट मेंटर, ग्रेट हेल्प. एंड आई लर्न दैट हाउ टू बी हम्बल, हाउ टू बी डिटेल ओरिएंटेड, हाउ टू बी सो मच केयरिंग फॉर पीपल. हम चाहें चाहे या ना चाहें हमें ऐसा कंडीशनिंग दी जाती है बचपन से कि अगर आपका कोई लीडर है या मैनेजर है तो मोस्ट प्रॉब्ली वो या तो खड़ूस होगा, या तो वो डांटने वाला होगा, या तो फिर
ऐसे ही होते हैं ना मैनेजर्स.
Not with me, as I said, not with me, but this is general general concept. I have been very lucky on that. But no, Tarun Bhargava was another level of where I saw the true leadership, you know, what caring actually means and what it means to be really detail oriented, what it means to be really doing something for someone without expecting anything in return. So I had so many good managers, but he was one of the great mentors I had. And then 2017 mein, when I went to US, that's another, I'm like full of stories, but that's another conversation. When I went there, I thought कि हम लोग तो अब तो सारे अंग्रेजों के आसपास ही रहेंगे, सब कुछ इंग्लिश में ही करेंगे, उनके साथ ही होगा. बट व्हेन आई वेंट देयर वी वर लिविंग इन अ कॉम्प्लेक्स व्हिच वाज फुल ऑफ इंडियंस ऑन इन ऑफिस आल्सो इट वाज वेरी प्रोफेशनल. सो आइदर वी वर नॉट मीटिंग टू मेनी अमेरिकन्स और दोज अमेरिकन्स दैट वी यूज्ड टू मीट वेर वेरी वेरी प्रोफेशनल. एंड आफ्टर अ फ्यू probably after a month or so since I was a toastmaster, I started feeling ki there is no growth happening. I mean, office is good, technology is good, everything is good, but there is no growth happening. And once you get that hunger from toastmaster, like something is missing. So then I started, and I was also concerned about my wife because I wanted her also to explore this toastmaster. So then I started exploring ki where can I get Toastmasters. I knew कि it America में start हुआ था, but I don't know कि कितना है, क्या है. And then as it turned out that there were multiple Toastmaster club. जो customer के लिए हम लोग काम करते थे, I was fortunate कि वहाँ पे भी एक Toastmaster club था, and I immediately joined, became very active there. And then I also joined a community Toastmaster. It's called Pioneer 17 Toastmaster. It's called Pioneer 17 because कि ये वर्ल्ड में 17th क्लब है, वर्ल्ड का 17वां क्लब है. फॉर दैट मैटर अभी इस समय वर्ल्ड में क्लोज टू 17,000 क्लब्स आर देयर. सो दैट वॉज लाइक 17th क्लब इन द वर्ल्ड अबाउट 87 ईयर ओल्ड नाउ. सो इट वॉज फॉर्म्ड इन 1934 और 35 एंड आई वेंट देयर and I met so many amazing Toastmasters and I had another, I would say my journey of 2.0 as Toastmaster 2.0 started there. I had my foundations back in India, but when I went to US, I started exploring more, growing more, learning more. And I became dual club member. उसके अलावा आई यूज टू विजिट सो मेनी अदर क्लब्स, आई यूज टू गिव स्पीचेस एंड प्ले एवरी रोल पॉसिबल. कॉम्पिटिशंस इज माई फेवरेट, यू नो दैट. आई यूज टू पार्टिसिपेट इन ईच एंड एवरी कॉन्टेस्ट पॉसिबल एंड दैट्स हाउ आई मेड सम लॉट ऑफ न्यू मेंटर्स. मार्क वॉल्टन his amazing personality. You know him personally, and he was so immaculate in helping me every time. जब भी मेरा कोई स्पीच है, जब भी मेरा कोई कॉम्पिटिशन है, he would personally, you know, help me. Another lady, GTM Meg Claxton, so experienced, so knowledgeable, and so humble. There were a number of people, Nora Hovey, Jerry Zimmer. So I think one of the best decisions in my life I took was to continue with Toastmaster in US, because that gave me another perspective of Toastmaster. So 2017 se leke 2019 was my Toastmaster 2.0, and due to some visa issues, I had to come back. That's a sad story and covered in another keynote, but 2019 July I came back to India, and I was in my hometown for some time, and then in October I joined the teacher's office, and apart from the usual teacher's thing, the usual work, what another thing I did was Toastmaster 3.0, to say the third journey, and this time the journey was more about giving than learning, receiving. Definitely every time you go, aapki learning hoti hai, aapki growth hoti hai. But this time, since I had done Toastmaster for 3+ years, I've learned so much. I wanted to give it back. And that's when I joined TCS Noida 6 Club again. I met so many new, young, dynamic, energetic guys like you, Gursimar, Naina, Madhuri, Smita, so many new members, and I was so privileged, and they were so respectful, so encouraging. I think that was another journey. So that's where my Toastmaster 3.0 started. I had so many mentors, and I thought it was my time to do pay forward, as I say, time to actually groom the next leaders, next communicators of Toastmaster. So I was so privileged to have you. You were. And do you want to talk about your story, or should I tell the story from my perspective?
I think there's a lot. I think I am still in my cocoon. There's a lot to do to come out of that cocoon. And once I become a butterfly, once I actually fly, then we can talk about me. Yeah. I feel I'm still in my cocoon. So not about me right now.
Sure, I think we can talk about the very first time. I mean, I think it was one of the meeting, Toastmaster meeting. They used to meet on Wednesday. So you attended the club meeting. I was also there. And then next
day, I used to run generally.
Yeah, you used to run after meeting. And I think it was next day or day after. And I used
can
to
I
have,
ask you that?
Yeah, I used to we have headphone or earphone, and I was listening to some very serious podcast, and I was like lost in thoughts and reflection, and suddenly you appeared, hi, and I was like, hello. And it was awkward for you and me both, but I think then from there on, I think our association has been great. One thing I love about Toastmaster is the personal connect, the genuine connect that you get from people is rare. I wouldn't say it's impossible, but it's rare to find outside, because you won't know that people really care for you or not. So this is one place where you get to network, you get to connect with people, and you touch their life. So, so that's when our association started, and chal raha hai. Abhi aapki journey ke bare baat nahi karni thi.
When I thought about what's a mentor, I actually never knew there's something called mentor. And kahin na kahin, meri Toastmasters journey, I think I owe a lot to you, because it was in a way incomplete. Kyunki isse pehle maine join kara tha Toastmasters, but I left it. Because hota na, there was never that motivation. But jab aap the to, jaise har week, we used to have weekly connects. And matlab wo aisa lagta tha, har week, we have to like, हरितोष विल कम एंड ही विल आस्क कि इस हफ्ते क्या करा, एंड मैं तो वैसे इतनी एक्साइटेड रहती थी सारी चीजों के लिए, आप जैसे भी कुछ भी मतलब बताते थे, आई यूज टू बी सो मच लाइक मतलब आई डोंट नो, देयर वाज सो मच एंथुसियाज्म देन एंड नाउ आल्सो कि मुझे सीखना है, मुझे जानना है. इनफैक्ट मतलब I used to go to that extent कि जैसे अगर if you're writing something in a meeting, so I used to peep in your paper also कि ये लिख क्या रहे हैं मतलब was another so I think I had lot of zest to learn things from you and I was very mentor बहुत generous थे कि सारी चीजें बता देते थे, समझा देते थे, कभी किसी चीज में ये नहीं बोलते थे, नहीं ये अभी ये नहीं बता रहा मैं. So it was for me, मैं बहुत ही enthusiastic थी, मेरे I think mentor उससे भी ज़्यादा enthusiastic थे. That is why that connect happened and जो भी मैंने whatever my journey has been, I owe every part of that journey to you because without you, it's incomplete and it's nothing actually.
You should be saying that. That's too generous of you. But yeah, I think let's not bore people with more such conversation. Let's change the gear and I think.
अब मैं सिर्फ एक चीज पूछना चाहूँगी आपसे कि एक छोटे सी जगह से, small town से आए आप, जौनपुर से, फिर आपका सफर गया बैंगलोर and then UK and US and again UK. तो आपने लाइफ में बहुत कुछ देखा. Then Toastmasters में आप मतलब distinguished Toastmaster बने. आपने डिविजन लेवल कॉन्टेस्ट जीता एंड यू हैव डन अ लॉट दिस ड्यूरिंग ऑल दीज इयर्स प्रोफेशनली पर्सनली. अब मेंटरिंग भी करी आपने इस साल. तो व्हाट इज योर टेक अवे फॉर यंग पीपल कि लाइक व्हाट इज योर सक्सेस मंत्रा और अ मंत्रा फॉर अ होलसम लाइफ लाइक यू नो दैट परफेक्ट बैलेंस ऑफ लाइफ बिकॉज आई सी you are that person who knows how to balance a lot. Like you know how to give time to family, then office, and then Toastmasters, and then mentoring and everything. So what is your takeaway for young people ki wo kis tarike se ek wholesome life leke jiye?
Thank you. I think bahut hi acha sawal hai aapka. I don't think I've achieved a lot of things, to be honest. I have so many things to achieve, but I'm also not going to be kehte na ki I'm not going to disobey or disrespect what I've earned so far in my journey. And I know sometimes it feels like ki abhi to kali tha, I am going to Sisu Mandir, and now next moment you think ki it feels like the blink, right? How it changed and how many things happened. So if I have to give you few advices for, especially for my young friends who are going to join their career or something, I'll probably give. And one of the reasons we did this interview was my brother-in-law asked me to talk about your journey and maybe some people will learn something. I'm not sure they will learn something, but yeah, I can definitely give my takeaways. First thing is never stop dreaming. At the same time, never be too rigid. What that means is you have to aspire to have great things in life, but you should also expect to have failures. बड़ा सोचोगे तभी बड़ा करोगे, लेकिन अगर सिर्फ यो सोचोगे जब बड़ा करोगे तभी कुछ करोगे तो कुछ नहीं कर पाओगे. मेरी लाइफ में बहुत सारे फेलियर्स हुए हैं. As I don't think I'm still success. I'm still starting, as I said, work in start or starting work. But I failed so many times. I never qualified to IIT. Or any regional engineering college. I studied from a private engineering college of UPTU, UP Technical University. Not to disregard the college, but I thought I could have done much better. First failure. Second failure, I prepared for management exams. I never could qualify. Never went to MBA college. That's second failure. The first time I gave a certification exam for Microsoft SharePoint, I failed in that as well. never got my money back. So, but I'm still here. It's not lost, right? I've failed, but I've gained so much also. So think about failure as a stepping stone, as a learning point, and keep the right mindset and keep yourself open. When you keep yourself open, you get new opportunities, you get new avenues.
हमेशा बोलते हैं ग्रोथ माइंडसेट.
करेक्ट.
मुझे वो चीज सबसे बेस्ट लगती है, ग्रोथ माइंडसेट. द डे यू अबाइड विद दैट, इट्स सो मच सॉर्टेड.
करेक्ट. आई हैव द बुक हियर. सो वन ऑफ माय हॉबीज इज गोइंग बैक टू बुक्स इन दिस कोविड 19. दिस बुक इज एन अमेजिंग बुक. आई हैव सो मेनी अमेजिंग बुक. दिस इज वन ऑफ माय फेवरेट, व्हिच टॉक्स अबाउट कि फिक्स्ड माइंडसेट क्या होता है और ग्रोथ माइंडसेट क्या होता है. और सो अगर आपकी लाइफ में ग्रोथ माइंडसेट, आप हर चीज का पॉजिटिव एस्पेक्ट देखोगे, देन यू विल ग्रो इन लाइफ. द सेकेंड थिंग इज दैट आई वॉन्ट टू टॉक अबाउट इज देयर इज नथिंग कॉल्ड टाइम मैनेजमेंट. इट्स ऑलवेज प्रायोरिटी मैनेजमेंट. यू कैन मैनेज टाइम, यू कैन मेक 24 hours, इवन 24 hours 1 second. It is that fixed 24 hours, fixed 12 months, fixed 365 or 66 days, depending on whether it's leap year or not. But what you can do is make the best use of those time, prioritize things. It's like a big ball game. It's like, वो देखा होगा ना सर्कस में, वो तीन चार बॉल एक साथ करते रहते हैं. That's how life is. You will have your work. You will have your personal life. You will have your social circle. You will have your learning. If you are somebody like me, you'll also have a Toastmaster, a big part of your life now. And you'll have to juggle with all of these. You will suffer. You'll be in pain, but you'll grow. So do not expect that it's going to be a bed of roses, whether it's before marriage or after marriage. Before college, after college, before job, after job, before Toastmaster, after Toastmaster. It's going to be a constant struggle. But this is where the learning happens. And as Tony Robbins said, that no, the real pleasure is not when you reach destination. Real pleasure is in the journey itself. So, असली जो कहते हैं ना, असली जो आनंद है, असली मजा है, वो उसमें नहीं है कि आप वहां पहुंच जाओ जहां आपको पहुंचना है. असली असली मजा उसमें है कि आप उसके लिए मेहनत करते रहो, नई नई चीजें सीखते रहो, नई नई बातें करते रहो, नए नए लोगों से मिलो, लोगों से कनेक्ट करो और कोशिश करो कि हम लाइफ में क्या नया कर सकते हैं, क्या अच्छा कर सकते हैं और कितना अच्छा कर सकते हैं. बस आई थिंक दीज टू आर माई लाइफ एडवाइसेस. Dream big, but don't be too stringent. Don't be too strict ki haan wahi dream hai to wahi hoga, otherwise kuch nahi hoga. Those people mostly fail. And second is it's priority management. And alag alag time pe alag alag cheezon ki priority hogi. Abhi aapki jo priority hai maybe 2-4 saal baad wo aapki priority nahi rahegi. Something else will become. और जो आपकी प्रायोरिटी अभी नहीं है वो बाद में आपकी प्रायोरिटी बन सकती है. सो आई थिंक अगर ये दो चीजें हम करें तो शायद लाइफ में थोड़ा और सक्सेसफुल हो सकते हैं. आई वुडन्ट से मोस्ट सक्सेसफुल बिकॉज़ आई डोंट नो व्हाट इज मोस्ट सक्सेसफुल, बट थोड़ा और सक्सेसफुल हो सकते हैं. एंड शायद मेरी तरह आपको भी इंटरव्यू देने का मौका मिल सकता है.
थैंक यू सो मच हरितोष, इट वाज अ फिनोमिनल इंटरव्यू विद यू. एवरी टाइम the positivity and the energy that you carry with yourself, it's infectious. It's totally infectious. I can vouch for this fact because the day, since the day I've met you until this day, I have every time I have had a talk to you, there's not a time, not a single time I have had an even an iota of negativity from you. And you know, this constant motivation of yours to grow every day, it inspires so many people, not just in clubs but outside the clubs and wherever you go. that is very scintillating and very specifically that can be identified. So I would like to thank you for taking out time and talking to me and making this a beautiful journal for so many people to watch and sharing your gems of wisdom with all of us. Thank you so much for this beautiful interview, for this amazing conversation that we have.
Thank you so much, Taiva. Thank you for agreeing to do this. I could not think about a better person who could.
Always.
Yeah. Take care. And as I say with everything now, it's like keep learning, keep growing, and keep going out of your comfort zone. Thank you so much.
Yes. Thank you.